Located in Doswell, Virginia, King's Dominion has been delighting visitors for almost 50 years. From its classic rides to its massive steel roller coasters, discover the history of this much-loved amusement park. The beginnings of King's Dominion lie in Ohio. King's Island had opened north of Cincinnati in 1972 and was an immediate success. Looking to capitalize on this, owners Taft Broadcasting decided to expand with a new park in another region of the country. A site in Virginia, north of Richmond, was chosen, with construction on the new park beginning on October 1st the same year. The design of this new venture would be based on that of King's Island, using the hub-and-spoke design with International Street at the entrance and a replica Eiffel Tower at its centre. A name would be chosen that would pay homage to its sister park, while using the nickname of the state of Virginia. By 1974, construction was so far along that a preview centre was opened, including a drive-through animal safari and the Scooby-Doo roller coaster. Opening on May 3, 1975, the new King's Dominion welcomed guests with 15 rides and attractions. Paying $7.50 and entering the park, visitors would find themselves on International Street, with its European architecture and majestic fountains. Up ahead, the Eiffel Tower would beckon guests to explore one of the four other lands. The Happy Land of Hanna-Barbera was based on the animation studio's characters and featured junior roller coaster Scooby-Doo. Lion Country Safari featured a number of flat rides. Its main attraction was a monorail tour around the animal paddocks. Coney Island emulated the similar area at King's Island and featured roller coasters Galaxy and Rebel Yell. Rebel Yell was a racing coaster with a similar design to the racer at King's Island. The last of the areas would be Old Virginia, celebrating the history of the state, and attractions included the park's log flume and a train ride. Opening day was better than anyone hoped. 50,000 people attended the park, with the same number waiting outside to enter. With this success, continued expansion came. King's Dominion installed one of the first modern inverting roller coasters in the country, with Shuttle Loop King Cobra in 1977. But the biggest expansion came in 1979. The Lost World was a massive mountain structure that contained three rides. The building was the largest attraction complex ever constructed at a regional park, and visitors could enjoy Voyage to Atlantis, Journey to the Land of Dews, and Time Shaft. By the 1980s, the park were adding new rides every season. 1982's wooden roller coaster Grizzly was quickly followed by Whitewater Canyon the following year. 1983 would also be the year that Taft Broadcasting sold its stake in the park. King's Dominion, along with sister parks King's Island and Carowinds, purchased by New Kings Entertainment Company, who would operate the park until the early 1990s. During this period, stand-up coaster Shockwave was introduced, as well as Arrow Loop at Anaconda and bobsled ride Avalanche. Avalanche has since been renamed Reptilian, but still remains the only Mack bobsled coaster in the country. Filling in two-thirds of Lake Charles to reclaim land, the park added Hurricane Reef in 1992. This new water park was included with park admission. King's Dominion was acquired by Paramount Parks in 1993. The new company would bring rides and attractions based upon their film and television franchises. In 1994, the park introduced a new area, Wayne's World. Themed to the films of the same name, the land featured wooden roller coaster Hurler. 1994 would also be the last year for the Lost World. Now nicknamed Smurf Mountain due to a ride re-theme, its remaining attractions would close with the mountain still standing. During the 90s and around the new millennium, King's Dominion continued to install new rides. The park taking advantage of emerging technologies and using cutting-edge roller coaster design. In 1996, indoor attraction The Outer Limits Flight of Fear became one of the first coasters in the world to use linear induction motors on its launch. LIMs would be used again 2 years later for Volcano the Blast Coaster. Volcano utilised the old mountain structure from the Lost World to create the now iconic attraction. A third launch coaster was added in 2001. Hypersonic XLC used a compressed air launch to propel riders from a standing start to 80 miles per hour in 1.5 seconds. Being a prototype, the roller coaster was plagued with technical problems and maintenance issues. Despite this, investment continued, with Ricochet installed the next year. Another launch would arrive in 2006. Italian Job Turbo Coaster took riders on a car chase during this themed attraction. Cedar Fair would purchase Paramount Parks the same year, taking control of King's Dominion and necessitating the removal of Paramount brands from its attractions. The closing of Geauga Lake provided the park with three new rides. One of these would be 2008's Dominator, a flawless roller coaster located close to the park entrance. The massive Intimidator 305 arrived in 2010. This intense gigacoaster was the park's largest capital investment to date and offered a unique layout with fast low-to-the-ground curves. I-305 was not as successful with the public as the park had hoped, and its reception led to the longest period without a new coaster the park had seen. It wasn't until 2018 that King's Dominion opened Twisted Timbers, working with RMC to transform the old hurler, creating a new hybrid ride. Following almost a year closed due to the global pandemic, King's Dominion reopened in 2021, announcing a refresh of the original park area Safari Village. The following year, Jungle Expedition opened, bringing new coaster Tumbili, as well as an updated new look for the land. The detailed immersion of Jungle Expedition indicated a new direction for King's Dominion, as well as a large plot available for future expansion.